Hi everyone, it's Professor Crimpton. In this video we're going to review composition of functions. So let's start this video with a question of how do you determine the derivative of a composition of functions? For example, what's the derivative of this function y equals the quantity 3x squared subtract 4x plus 5 raised to the 7th power? We have never seen a function like this before. We've seen functions where you have parentheses that's raised to the 2nd power and we've multiplied that out using the FOIL method and we've also taken the derivative after that. Or, if it was to the 2nd power, we wrote it out twice and we took the derivative using the product rule in the last section. But we haven't taken the derivative of a function where it's raised to a different power other than 2. So to find the derivative of this function, we're going to require a more advanced differentiation rule, which is called the chain rule. The word chain in the chain rule comes from the fact that the function is formed by composition of two functions. You have an inside function that's inside the parentheses, but then you also have an outside function that's raised to the 7th power. The chain rule allows us to find derivatives of composite functions in terms of the derivatives of the inside and the outside functions that make up the composite function. So in this section, we're going to first review composite functions, and then in the next video, we'll introduce the chain rule through a special case of the general power rule. So in this video, we're going to review composite functions by identifying and defining them. So composite functions, we're going to first review the definition of a composite function and then identify what's called the inside or the inner and the outer functions or the outside function, which we're going to find out is necessary in finding the derivative using the chain rule in the next video. So composition of functions, when the output of one function is used as the input of the other function, we call the entire operation the composition of functions. And it's written this way, f parentheses g of x, and it's read as f of g, so it's f of g of x, or you can say f composed with g at x. So an alternative notation for composition uses the composition operator, so a little tiny circle means composition of functions, so you can have f composed with g of x, so it's f of g of x, or f composed with g at x. And so these two are exactly the same, f composed with g at x is the same thing as f of g of x. Since it looks like the function g of x is being substituted into the function f of x, g of x is called the inner function or the inside function, and the f of x is called the outside or the outer function. So in other words, a composite function is a combination of two functions called the inner function and the outside function or the outer function. For example, this is a composite function. M of x is the quantity x squared plus 4 all raised to the 3rd power. Now you could simplify this function. You could write out x squared plus 4 times x squared plus 4 times x squared plus 4, but the multiplication would be very tedious to do. If you write the function this way, you can identify the inside and the outside function pretty quickly. So notice that the inside function is what's inside the parentheses. It's x squared plus 4, so that's a quadratic function. And the outside function is what's being cubed. So you have a cubic function as the outer function. So before we talk about the chain rule in the next video, we'll be given functions of this form and we're going to have to figure out what's the inside and the outside function. So let's do that. The question is, if y is the outside function, f of u, and u equals g of x represents the inner function or the inside function, then what is f of u and g of x for this composite function m of x? And it's defined this way. F is the outside function, g is the inside function, so it's f of g of x, or f composed with g at x. So if y is x squared plus 4 all to the 3rd power, that means the inside function is x squared plus 4, because that's what it looks like you're plugging into the outside function. So x squared plus 4 is the g of x, and the outside function is f of u, and since the outside function is a cubic function, it's u cubed. And so to check, if you plug this function g of x as your inside function, if you plug that into f of x, the outside function, you should get m of x, which was the composite function. So let's do an example of actually finding composite functions if we know the inside and the outside functions. So example one, composite functions. Let f of x and g of x be two functions defined as f of x is negative 4x squared plus 9, and g of x is 2x minus 7. Find the following composite functions. So number one, find the composite function f composed with g at x, or by definition of composite function, f of g of x. So f is the outside function and g is the inside function. So the inner function is g of x, which is called u, It's 2x minus 7. And the outside function is y equals f of u. So replace all the x's with a u, negative 4u squared plus 9. That's your outside function. So now how do you find the composite function? You use substitution. You take the function g of x, which was 2x minus 7, and you plug it in to the outside function, which was f. So g of x was 2x minus 7, so replace that inside the parentheses. And so now you need to find f of 2x minus 7. So this is all about function notation now. You're taking all the variables in the function f, and you're replacing them with 2x minus 7. So negative 4u squared plus 9 is now negative 4. Replace the u with the inside function, 2x minus 7. That needs to be squared, and then you need to add 9. Now let's do a little bit of simplifying. Negative 4 times 2x minus 7 in parentheses squared plus 9 is negative 4 times negative 2x minus 7 times itself, and then plus 9 outside the parentheses. So keep the negative 4 on the outside, and now we need to use floral to multiply 2x minus 7 with itself. So 2x times 2x will give you 4x squared inside the parentheses. 2x times negative 7 is negative 14x. Negative 7 times 2x is negative 14x. And negative 7 times negative 7 gives you 49. Now that's all being multiplied by negative 4. So negative 4 times, in parentheses, 4x squared minus 14x plus 49. And then you have plus 9 on the outside. And now you can distribute the negative 4 through the parentheses. So negative 4 times 4x squared gives you negative 16x squared. Negative 4 times negative 14x is positive 56x. And again, negative 4 times negative 14x gives you another 56x. Negative 4 times 49 is negative 196. And then you have the plus 9 outside the parentheses. So if you combine like terms, the composite function, f composed with g of x, will be negative 16x squared plus 112x, subtract 187. All right, number 2. This time we're going to do another composite function. This time, g composed with f at x, which means you're finding g of f of x. Now notice, you reverse the roles of f of x and g of x. This time, f of x is being substituted into g of x. So that means f of x is the inside function, or the inner function, and g is the outside function, or the outer function. The inner function is u equals f of x. It's negative 4x squared plus 9. And the outside function is y equals g of u. Take all the x's in the function g and replace them with a u. So instead of 2x minus 7, now it's 2u minus 7. And how do you find g composed with f at x? You take the function f of x and replace it with what it was in the problem. So negative 4x squared plus 9. That's going to be plugged in to the function g of x. So wherever you see a variable in the function g, now it's going to be replaced with negative 4x squared plus 9. So the function g is 2 times u. So 2 times what we're plugging in is the function f of x. So negative 4x squared plus 9 goes inside parentheses. And then you need to subtract 7. And so there's a little bit of simplifying again. You can distribute the 2 through the parentheses. So 2 times negative 4x squared gives you negative 8x squared. 2 times 9 gives you 18, and the negative 7 was outside the parentheses. And so after you combine like terms, you'll have negative 8x squared plus 11. That's your composite function, g composed with f at x. And so notice, if you reverse the roles of the inside and the outside function as we did in these last two problems, you will not necessarily get the same answer. So in other words, if you find f at g of x, or f composed with g at x, that's not the same thing as g composed with f at x, or g of f of x. So if you reverse the inside and the outside functions, don't expect that you'll get the same answer every single time. Now, when you form composite functions, the operation is called composition. So you are composing two functions to form a new function. So f composed with g is a new function, or g composed with f, it's a new function. However, sometimes you want to reverse this process of composition. Say you're given a function and you want to find out what is the inside and the outside function. This is what's called decomposing a function, so that you can express it as a composition of two functions. So example 2, we're going to write a function as the composition of two functions. This function m of x has already been formed through composition. So m of x is the quantity x plus 1 all squared, plus 2 times the quantity x plus 1, and then subtract 3. We need to determine what are the two functions, y equals f of u, and u equals g of x, so that when you do compose these two functions together, you get the function m of x as f is the outside function, and g is the inside function. So now look at this composite function. What function does it look like you're plugging in? It looks like I'm plugging in x plus 1 here, and I'm plugging in x plus 1 in here. So we're going to call the inside function u equals g of x as x plus 1. Now, what does it look like you're plugging x plus 1 into? Because that would be the outside function. The outside function is y equals f of u. It looks like I'm plugging in here, so that needs to be a variable that's being squared, so u squared, plus 2 times, I'm plugging in here, so that needs to be a variable, so 2 times u, and then subtract 3. So f of u is u squared plus 2u subtract 3. So if you have the two functions defined this way, then you'll actually have this composite function m of x. So this is what's called decomposing a composite function. We found two functions, the inside and the outside function, so that if you did do composition, you will get m of x. So let's try one more of these. Example 3, write in a function as a composition. Given the composite function, m of x is the square root of x squared plus 5. So again, this function has already been formed by using composition of functions. Find the two functions, y equals f of u, and u equals g of x, so that if you do compose these two functions together, you do get this function m of x, as f is the outside function and g is the inside function. So again, the question is, what does it look like you're plugging in as a function? Well, inside the square root, you have x squared plus 5. So let's call the inside function u equals g of x squared plus 5. And now, if I'm plugging x squared plus 5 into a function, what would be that function we're plugging into? The outside function would have to be y equals f of u, and it looks like I'm plugging in to a square root, so square root of, and this is what I'm plugging in, so that has to be the variable, so square root of u. And so if you have these two functions, g of x is x squared plus 5, and f of u is square root of u, if you do composition, where f is the outside function and g is the inside function, you will get this composite function. So this is a good place to stop our video after we've reviewed composite functions. If you have any questions about any of the examples in this video, please let me know. Or if you have any questions while you work on the homework for this section, please let me know that as well. And I'll see you at the next video when we talk about the chain rule.